Gentlemen, let's do it in Detroit. We'll be showing off some Detroit gold, and first I would like to introduce Ms. Tina Bassett and Mr. Adolphus Mungo, Director and Deputy Director of DPI. Where are you? We want to thank them for pulling this together for us, and we know we'll be very, very successful. My name is Ted Jordon, and I'm the Deputy Director of Recreation, and I'll be with you throughout the program. We have some very good things planned for you. You have often heard us talk about the city jewels. Today, you will meet some of our people jewels. To begin that process, I would like to introduce Mr. Dan Krichbaum, Director of the City Recreation Department, and also a people jewel. Dan?
Thank you very much, Ted. The purpose of today's press conference is really twofold. One, we wanted to introduce to the press and to others some of our true Olympic hopefuls for next summer's games. And secondly, we wanted to give you an idea of who Olympic hopefuls might be 4 years from now or 8 years from now. So we also want to introduce to you some of our promising athletes who are coming along. I think it's remarkable that a municipal recreation department has had such success in terms of turning out world-class athletes, not only in the major sports like Willie Horton in baseball and Ralph Simpson in basketball, Spencer Haywood, to name just a few, Joe Lewis, of course, but also we're developing world-class athletes in some of the sports that aren't so well covered. So today, for instance, you'll get an introduction to modern rhythmic gymnastics, which for the first time in 1984 will be in the World Olympics in Los Angeles. We're very proud of what this department has been able to do in terms of the fiscal constraints that we've been operating under. And yet to have a wide spectrum program, to have a broad-based program where all the youth in the city get an opportunity, and then on top of that to be able to develop some world-class athletes, I think it's a remarkable thing for a municipal recreation department. I would like to introduce some of our guests here today who, from my point of view, are not only world-class athletes, but are world-class people, and give a great deal of support to the city and to the Recreation Department. Most of you are familiar with our Hall of Famer, Dick Lane from the National Football League, and he'll be on the program a little later. You probably also know well a future Hall of Famer, Lem Barney from the Michigan Consolidated Gas Company. I think Lem is a great example of what volunteers in the private sector are doing for our department. He puts on football clinics for us, he puts on basketball clinics, his corporation donates to the recreation department and supports our summer basketball program as well as many other programs. One of my heroes when I was growing up in a small town in Ohio was Hayes Jones, who accomplished so much in track and was a world-class and Olympic sprinter. And Hayes Jones now works for Stroh's, and I'd like him to stand. I must say that I have many enjoyable aspects of my job. I think being part of the new riverfront development downtown in terms of the new parks that we're creating is a wonderful thing. All the programs that our department puts on is a wonderful thing. But at the heart of my job is what we do in the community centers. And we have 35 community centers, and the person that supervises the work in the community centers, that supervises most of our athletic programs, is our Superintendent of Recreation, Mr. Chuck Lewis. And I'd like him to come forward now. Chuck?
I'm delighted to have you all here this morning. We have a chance to showcase, obviously, some of our talented young people who have some potential for doing great things in the future. But my job is a very simple one this morning. I'm supposed to tell you about probably the nation's most comprehensive recreation program. And I've got to do that in about 2 minutes, Dan tells me. Obviously, we're focusing on athletic programs here this morning. But I want you to know that we cover a broad spectrum of athletic activities in our 35 recreation centers, numerous school recreation centers in our parks and playgrounds throughout the year. Football, baseball, softball, volleyball, soccer, you name it, we've got it for all ages. But recreation is more than sports. Recreation includes a variety of things, and so our programs also includes arts and crafts, social activities, cultural activities. Most of you are probably aware of the festivals that take place at Hart Plaza. You might not know that our staff coordinates those ethnic festivals during the summertime. We also run a residential camp near Brighton, Michigan, where we send youngsters throughout the summer, and we do some year-round activities for small groups. Special populations are served by our specialized services unit. Hopefully, you'll have a chance to take a look at some of the handicapped swimmers who have participated in some of the Special Olympic programs that we've been involved in. The thrust today is to begin to provide an array of services from our recreation centers. And so we, over the past few years, have been developing what we call multi-service centers. By that, we mean we're working with a variety of human service agencies so that we are providing all kinds of leisure-related services out of our recreation centers. We've got a number of futuristic kinds of things in the works. We want to begin to take a look at the negative recreation problems that confront us as we develop the multi-service center concept. So we're working with agencies to begin to address things like child abuse, spouse abuse. We are working to provide employment opportunities for young people so that they have some career aspirations. You ought to know that recreation probably is the world's largest industry when you take all of it into consideration. So we're happy to develop champions in our programs, but also to be able to provide this array of regular traditional recreation activities and leisure services, as well as to begin to address some of the problems that we will be facing in the future. We live in an age of leisure. Almost 30 years of your life will be devoted to leisure and creative activities. We want to be a part of helping people in the city of Detroit use those leisure hours wisely, and we want to be sure that you help us publicize the activities that go on so we can do it in Detroit. Thank you very much.
Okay, I just wanted to say a few words about the individual sports that we're covering here today. In figure skating, we have the Michigan junior champion with us today, whose name is Michael Orr. He didn't want to come into the press conference. He's a little nervous, and so he's practicing his routines in the arena. But he's a very fine young man, and I think we will hear a lot from him in the future in terms of figure skating. One of the success stories in this department and this city over the last few years.
Thank you, Dan. You know, I was sitting here and I was thinking about last night. I woke up about 12. The TV woke me up about 1 o'clock. And I look on TV and I seen some Olympic young ladies on and a young man that are tumblers or whatever it is, you know. And I said, boy, look here, we got to wake up at 12, 2 o'clock in the morning to see, you know, future American gold medal winners. So you don't have to do that with the PAL hockey group here. We have a bunch of young men who, some 8 years ago, when I came to PAL to be the director, and some doctor said, you say you put $17,000 in a hockey program, and there's no black kids playing hockey. So right away, I started saying, put somebody on there, let them fall down, get up, fall down again. So today we have with us the second champions that have gone to the National PAL tournaments and won. 2 years ago, we had the really small guys that started out, and they went and won. They won in Lincoln Park first, and then they went to the Nationals up in Bridgeport and won. So this morning, we have them here, and we had to get them out of school. We got to get them back in school. From Jack Adams Arena, we have the pal, the Squirts, right? Okay, I know I'm going to get these pretty hard. DeConi Cooper, Harry T. Gaskin, fourth, Frank Oldrie, and Dwayne Walker, Leon Williams, and the coaches are Rudolph Stevens, Hal Sheldon, Jack Adams, Frank Ogletree. So they are this year's, and they just come back on February 23rd from the National Power Hockey Tournament as our champion representing us in Detroit. I might say in the Power program, we do have more people who are going to the Olympics or going to the tryouts of the Olympics this year. We have one boxer. We have even a chess player who hopefully that's what he wants to become.
Raise your hand. Thank you. He's done a terrific job in terms of developing our boxing program. And we have a number of boxers who not only are Olympic contenders, but have a good chance for Olympic medals in Los Angeles this summer. I also want to introduce, and I hope the press will take time to talk, to two of our boxing coaches, our coaches from the Coleman Young Center, John Brown. And John, would you please stand up, and James Kennard. Later on, you'll be visiting our boxing room off of the gym, and Mr. Kennard and Mr. Brown will be there to answer questions about the daily boxing program that goes on in all of our centers. I think we also will have some of our Olympic contenders here this morning for you to watch and talk to, people like Steve McCrory, Ricky Womack, and Frank Tate. So we've done a good job in terms of boxing, and we have some definite possibilities for gold medals and medals in this summer's Olympics. We also have had a tremendous, in Detroit, a tremendous record in terms of fencing. It's not a well-known sport, but again, we think that we should publicize our many fine individual athletes who are into the individual sports. And today we have a fencing team with us, and I'd like to introduce their coach. John, would you stand up? John Zilkowski. And one of the finest young fencers in the Midwest, Anita Hawkins. Anita, would you stand up? Thank you. Later on, they're going to be putting on a short fencing demonstration. Finally, in modern rhythmic gymnastics, which is the new sport that I talked about previously, we have two of our coaches here, the head of our program, Dr. Mironov. Would you stand up, Vladimir? And Rosa Litvakova. Rosa, would you stand up? Two of our modern rhythmic gymnasts are contenders for the United States Olympic team. Xenia Mironov, Vladimir's wife, was the coach of the year last year in the total gymnastics sport. And we had the number one ranked modern rhythmic gymnast in the country this past year, who certainly will be on the United States Olympic team. That's Michelle Berube. She's not here at this point, but I think she'll be here later on, and we'll have the Tyndall gymnasts and the Kroll gymnasts who will be demonstrating this exciting new sport of modern rhythmic gymnastics. We're going to provide all of these youngsters with medallions, and I won't do that at this point, but I would like to call up one particular young person who is very close to me, because we've kind of grown up together in the recreation department, and she has grown up and matured tremendously in the sport of modern rhythmic gymnastics. She also is a contender for the United States Olympic team this summer, and she's won many awards across the country and across the world, And I'd like her to come up and receive one of our medals, kind of representing our possibility for the Detroit Gold. Wendy Hilliard, would you come up?
Like to thank the Detroit Recreation Department. As he said, rhythmic gymnastics is a very new sport. For the first time, it will be in the Olympics. And Detroit is one of the leading centers of rhythmic gymnastics. And we're very fortunate to have rhythmic gymnastics in a recreation department. We'll have a lot of gymnasts coming up for the 88 Olympics and 92 Olympics. We have great coaches, great future coaches. And I just want to thank the City of Detroit and the Recreation Department for giving Detroit and myself the opportunity to participate in rhythmic gymnastics. Thank you.
Okay, the way we would like to handle this is we'd like you all now to follow the yellow-shirted Do It in Detroit guides, go into the arena, the ice arena.
Thank you.